Hello everyone and welcome back to the Software Pulse, a brand new weekly bulletin all about the latest software and productivity applications. So I really appreciate all the lovely comments from the previous one. I did take into notes there won't be any bouncing screenshots in this one, so thanks very much to all of the people that mentioned that in the comments. So without further ado guys, let's dive in. Just before we dive into this episode of the Software Pulse, thanks to our sponsor, SetApp, who has sponsored this full week here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Now, SetApp is a subscription service for Mac users, allowing them access to hundreds of Mac apps inside of one suite at a set monthly rate. It's a pretty impressive application, and you can check out my full review in the description below. So, a big thank you to those guys for sponsoring this week. So the first exciting thing in the news this week is Gmail relaunching with a new redesign. Now this is the first big redesign since 2011, which is absolutely amazing, and it's something that Google are taking a lot of attention to. Now in terms of the new productivity side of stuff, you may have seen the bar on the right hand side. Now this includes Calendar, Google Keep, and Tasks, which is a brand new task management application from Google. So that's an exciting update from Gmail. Next up is Trello. Trello have basically overhauled their homepage. The new Trello homepage allows you to see all of the boards you're part of, all of the notifications, and even complete, dismiss items, and star them for later. Now it's a really almost like a dashboard to your Trello experience, allowing you to see essentially a news feed of all your activities. Now in this latest update, Trello has even revamped their notification center, allowing you to see a little more richer notifications and more effective ones. In more Google news, we have Google Tasks now available on iOS and Android. Now the application is damn simple. It is nothing more than just being able to add tasks, schedule them for later in terms of your due date, adding subtasks, and just having this clean design. Now of course you can have the list view and different lists, but that's really it. Now many people have been asking, what is it compared to Microsoft To-Do? And I would actually put it a little lower in the charts, just below Microsoft To-Do, mainly due to its My Day function and its theming that it doesn't have. Now guys, you're probably wondering what the hecky decky is happening with the To-Do scheduler. Now Amir, the CEO of Todoist or Doist, has shared a screenshot of what it looks like. Now just a few little notes, it does look like it's a redesigned experience that is a pull-up experience, allowing you to essentially pick a task and reschedule it. But it looks a little more intricate and Todoist seem to be working very hard on it. Now in other news, Remember the Milk has officially released a Drive integration. Now certainly in the Facebook group, the Keep Productive Facebook group, which you can join below, has been getting excited about this one, so it's definitely worth checking it out. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I'm really slow on this piece of news, 2 weeks ago or so, Asana released a brand new timeline function. Now, our friend Paul Miners over at paulminers.com made a full review of this one and his opinions on the platform. Now, the timeline function is pretty impressive, and I'll definitely bring in Paul to get to talk about it in a few more weeks. But it essentially opens up Asana to being a bit more of a functional resource outside of just boards and calendar. Now, in other news, OneNote sadly has shut down their 2016 edition, and it's something that many people are getting a bit sad about, but that's totally okay. It's just something that OneNote are sort of trying to refine and make better, and of course will take time. But in other news, Evernote have launched a new Windows 10 edition, and it includes a few more tweaks and updates to the UI, making it a little bit better. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by. A huge thank you again to SetApp. You can check out my full review in the description below, but SetApp's a great resource and it's highly recommended when it comes to Mac users trying to reduce the amount of applications they've got. Anyway guys, thank you so much for the feedback. I'm looking forward to seeing you next week for the Software Pulse. Anyway guys, make sure you have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.